Hello, my name is Brian. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a Knowledge Advanced channel. Creating a channel is like creating a document template. They define what fields and properties are required to create a particular type of article. For example, an FAQ channel may only have two fields to fill in when creating a document: question and answer fields. The reference implementation does not contain any channels. I am verifying that my demo environment does not yet have a channel by navigating to Configuration, Authoring, Repository, and clicking List. I am clicking Add Channel now to create my demo environment's first channel. Give the channel a name and click the page somewhere to automatically create the reference key. These keys are used for things like document importing from comma-separated value files, so it's important to make it intuitive. Notice the document ID prefix has also auto-populated, but with only two characters. I will add a Q here to complete the FAQ prefix. This way, the document ID number will appear for this channel as FAQ and then the number 1, 2, or so on. There are quite a few tools available to create a specialized channel that I don't really need for my demo. The use case for these are all listed in the documentation. Later on, I will be demonstrating how automatic language translation requests are configured and processed. To enable that demonstration, I'll want to be sure to enable both English and Spanish on this channel. Also, I wanted to use my new workflow to ensure content created goes through the review process before it becomes available to the public. Underneath the selected workflow, there are some options to select that will trigger when a document is going to enter workflow, such as, is the product or category assigned to the document changed? Will it trigger the document to enter workflow? Another option to notice is the last one. This one can be used only to allow documents to be edited by the people who are assigned to the workflow and only during that workflow step. I'll go ahead and leave mine unchecked to make it possible for folks who are not part of workflow to edit the document. Here are the categories that I created earlier. Notice I can select one or more at a time and click Add to include them in the categories available to this channel's authors. The same goes for products. Now that I have saved my general channel settings, it is time to define the fields that are provided to authors. Click Schema. Notice on the right the controls titled Add Attribute and Add Node. Think of attributes as the fields for authors to fill in, and think of Node as a predefined set of fields for authors to fill in as many times as needed. For example, a node may be required to capture all of the product engineers associated with a particular document. But having an endless list of blank fields in the channel for like the name, email, and phone number of each engineer would be very tedious and ugly. We could instead create a node that contains three fields, name, email, and phone, and provide this to authors when they need it. Authors will need to push an add button to create a set of new fields in the document to fill in. They can click this as many times as they need to create more sets of product engineer contact fields. I am clicking Add Attribute to create a single field. Provide a name for the field and click off it to populate the key. Select the type of field from the Attribute Type dropdown. This is my subject line for the channel. I will want to keep this field short and simple, so I will select Text Field. Notice once I select text field, the check mark below titled Included Master Record Identifier becomes selectable. This is because only text fields can be used as a record identifier. A master record identifier is a fancy way of saying title of document, such as when viewing a list of documents from the console. I will select all searching options to make it easier for authors and admins to find content inside the console. There is also an option to exclude a field from workflow. For example, if we had an internal notes field that is not something we want to review, we can uncheck this to not trigger workflow when the field's content changes. I will require authors to fill in this field and save. The next field I am adding will be where the authors may want to type a lot more content. Most commonly, rich text area is used to provide a large area with formatting tools to authors. For this demo, I will just use text area, providing a large area to enter basic text, but without the formatting tools. I have not created groups in my environment, but if I did have them, it would be possible for me to create fields that are only visible to selected groups. This is a very powerful feature, allowing documents to be segmented by audience, such as to provide more detail to support technicians versus the general public. The group configuration options are actually not shown until you select to restrict the field by user group. Notice how they expand. I've now created an FAQ channel that requires two fields to be filled in, question and answer, and it will follow our review workflow.